Join us this week as we attempt to tackle the Washington, D.C. metro system.
Come on, figure it out.
I think we're going to go to the Smithsonian. Stop. But I don't quite know what we're doing.
To visit the powerful and moving Holocaust Museum. Along the way, I passionately defend why sharing side dishes and drinks at a restaurant is totally acceptable.
Because we have an understanding
that
when we're somewhere like this, like McDonald's or a sandwich shop, that we each get a sandwich, we share the side.
And then provide some comedic relief as I battle with a messy ice cream cone. We wrap up with a partial tour of historic Gettysburg, doing a short dive into one of the most significant moments in American history.
We're going to see how this goes today. It's a Sunday, so it's a weekend day, and we're going to D.C. Specifically, we're going to the Holocaust Museum. Mm-hmm. And we'll probably see some other sites while we're there. I just wonder how busy it's going to be.
Yeah, hopefully not too busy. The parking at the metro station that we're going to take, that was the recommendation on Facebook, was to just park at a metro station and take the subway in. So this will be a first. Never been on a subway.
Yeah, we don't do these very often, so it should be interesting finding our way around using those. Mm-hmm. So anyway, wish us luck. I hope it's not too busy. Yeah. Should be kind of cool. The Holocaust Museum should be really interesting.
Yes.
So hopefully it's not too much of a downer. But first, let's see. We got to get to the metro station, and then we're going to grab lunch and then go from there. So, all right, we're off. Now what, genius?
I don't know.
Come on, figure it out.
I think we're going to go to the Smithsonian. Stop. But I don't quite know what we're doing, so I might go ask this person.
This is probably smart. She's just going to go ask for help. We don't know what the heck we're doing.
All right. We each need our own SmartTrip card.
Okay.
They're $2 a piece.
Okay.
That's just the fee. And then it's round trip, it's going to be $5 a piece. So.
Okay, so do you know how to do it now?
Yes.
Okay. I have my doubts.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, there's one card. There's two cards. Now the question is, did you load them right?
Well, it should be, because he said round trip is going to be $5, plus the cost of card is $2,
okay.
So $7 per card, and I paid $14.
All right, we'll see. Yep. Oh, look at that. I feel so, I don't know, cultured now or something. I don't know. All right, we got to figure it out, right? We think we have it figured out. We hope we have it figured out.
If not, we're going to be like the guy on speed.
We're at the airport.
Yeah, so?
I already seen the airport.
So that was interesting. For us simple folk, us non-city folk, that was different.
That was different, yes. I did not like writing backwards, you know, motion sickness and all.
The most important stop of the day is we're stopping at the National Museum of Asian Art.
Because we're hoping they have a bathroom.
Yeah, we gotta go to the bathroom. Go to a restaurant, you order whatever you want to eat. And next thing you know, she's digging in, helping herself to anything that you order.
Because we have an understanding
that
when we're somewhere like this, like McDonald's or a sandwich shop, that we each get a sandwich, we share the size.
That is so not true.
We agreed on it years ago.
That is so not true.
Because I can't eat an entire side by myself, whether it's fries or like he just got macaroni and cheese.
If I would have known she wanted mac and cheese, I'm fine with it. I'll get a bigger one.
They didn't have a bigger one.
Then I would have got to.
But I don't need to.
Well, I would have helped. I would have helped you finish the second one.
Oh no, we had agreed years
no,
ago.
No, we did not.
I can't, and you don't need. So.
The only thing that this has ever really applied to is French fries, and now I guess it applies to everything. Yep. Guys, you know what I'm talking about.
Because we always share a drink too, so, I mean, hello, we share a side. Because, like I said, I can't eat it all, and he doesn't need to eat it all, so I'm helping both of us.
This is all just noise. This building right here is the Department of Agriculture. It's huge. We're about, I don't know, two-thirds of the way down.
It's an entire city block.
And I would wager money that because it's a government building, 80% of the people that work in there, they're not even needed.
Yep.
Which means this building is 80% too big. I'd put money on it.
Yeah.
So that was a good museum to visit, the Holocaust Museum. Honestly, if you paid attention in high school, none of that was real news.
Mm-hmm.
But it basically started from the 1920s, where Hitler first showed his face all the way up through his rise to power, through the start of the war, or the treatment of the Jews, all the way through the war, and then ended with, you know, the liberation of the Jews and eventually, you know, Germany's defeat and Hitler's defeat. So a very cool museum to go to. And then as another note here, active duty military or veterans, you don't have to get your timed ticket, right? Because they do it on a timed ticket basis. So basically you walk in, you get a ticket for a certain time, and that's when you can go through. If you're active duty military or veteran, you walk up, you tell them that, and you can get in immediately. But great museum, great tour. Glad we did it. Mm-hmm. It's really the only thing we're doing here today. We got some lunch, we got some ice cream, and now we're gonna find the metro back.
Very expensive ice cream. Yeah. We stopped at an ice cream boba truck. Oreo milkshake, swirl cone, $18.
Yeah. There's lots of food trucks and stuff down here though. Food trucks, ice cream trucks, you name it. It's down here.
And mine is like disintegrating in my hands.
Mm. Yeah, I'm glad I got the shake. All right.
There's like three ice cream trucks behind us, and there were probably three more that flipped a U-ey. because they were notified somehow by a lookout that the cops were on their way. I'm assuming that they have to be, they can only be down here with permits, and I'm just guessing they didn't have permits because they literally were just like, whoop, gone.
So it wasn't really that they, what did you say, flipped a U-turn or whatever. They were all out here operating like it was just a normal business day. There must have been 10 of them. And then all of a sudden, some guy came running across the street yelling at them. Obviously, he was the lookout, and they all closed up their windows and sped off all at the same time, like 10 or 15 of them all at the same time. That was the strangest thing. And then, of course, that cop car that you saw in the background there started chasing some of them down. So that was one of the oddest things I've ever seen. It's like having a toddler. Look at this.
It's like I've got it on my jacket. I've had to wipe it off my feet. I'm a mess.
What the hell's wrong with you?
All right, we're gonna see if we can go navigate the metro again.
Yeah.
We got here, so.
Yeah, it's not too hard. It's pretty easy to navigate.
Yeah.
Round trip on the metro to go see the museum, $14.
Yep.
Ice cream after the museum, $18. Watching Candice eat her ice cream like a three-year-old, priceless.
I couldn't help it. It was melting all over. Like, the bottom of the cone totally disintegrated, and it was like dripping out the bottom. It's dripping down the sides. I paid $18 for that. I was gonna eat it, darn you.
Three-year-old.
Are you going to get a grown-up club?
I am going to get a grown-up club. I think that's the blue ones or the black ones. This one's mine.
Okay.
I called it.
All right.
Choose mine. Your weapon wisely. Oh, we didn't have... Oh, they do have scorecards down there.
They
but no.
do. Whoop.
And they even have pencils. And this is all free.
Yeah.
All right. Give me a ball.
You would like a blue ball for your blue toe.
Well, it's more purple, but yeah.
And... I think we'll go blue and pink. Ooh, actually, no, I changed my mind. I want purple.
Oh, okay. All right, well, I don't know which one's hole number one. Probably this one. Luck. Not a word. Oh, come on, man. It smells terrible out here. I don't know if you can smell that.
No.
I have super poop senses, and it smells like poop out here. Of course I didn't get it on camera, but that was a hole in one.
I don't know if I believe him.
How does that make you feel?
So sad. So sad.
Here you go. Look, looks like I got a hole in one. You see that one? I got that hole in one on camera. And you can't deny it now. I have proof for forever. The entire YouTube world knows I got a hole in one.
Yeah, okay.
Well, we just stopped keeping score because I'm whooping her so bad. Actually, we're getting bored, so we're only playing the interesting holes. So, we're not keeping score anymore.
Yeah, most of the holes are just like, hit it straight line.
Yeah, pretty much. Oh. Well, that was by far the most exciting thing I've done all day.
Thrilling. Well,
I don't know if it was the most interesting, but it was the most exciting. It was definitely the least painful. So we've got some time today between campgrounds.
We are at the Gettysburg National Military Park Museum and Visitor Center.
All right, there you go. So we're going to check this out. And we got a little bit of footage of coming in so we can share what that looks like if you're hauling an RV. Mm-hmm. There are RV spots over here. Now, I will say this. If this is busy with RVs, and if you have a long rig with a towed, or you have a long rig with a tow vehicle like us, those spots aren't long enough.
Yeah, we were sticking out 6 feet.
Yeah, so we ended up having to park sideways, but today it's not super busy. But there is a lot of room back here for RVs and buses and so forth. So maybe on a weekend we wouldn't be able to park, you know, sideways in these spots, but today it worked out fine. So we're gonna go check this out. And I don't know how long this is gonna take. We're gonna check it out. We got a dog with us, so I don't know how much we're gonna be able to see today. But we'll figure it out. All right, so the command decision was made here that we're going to stop what we're doing. Wicket's kind of a turd sometimes, especially when he's out in public. But we're going to just head on to the campground. We're only a couple of miles away, and I think it's only about 30 minutes until we can pull in there and get set up. So we're just going to go over there, and then we'll come back later and check it out. So wrap it up for now and then get all set up and come back.
Yep.
All right, we're here back for round two. We got rid of the dog. We got rid of the rig. We got rid of the cats. But now I'm tired. So I don't know how long we're going to stay here. What do you think?
Yeah, we'll probably get a feeling for kind of just the overall picture. And then we'll start the auto tour. And he doesn't have to do any driving.
Driving. I could do lots of driving because it's 24 miles. I'm not walking.
It's up to 20 walking. Yeah. I think so. I'm tired too. Free portion of the visitor center. There are some exhibits and a movie that you can pay for, but since we didn't really have time to do that, we decided to skip it for this tour. But I think we will definitely make this a future stop and do all of that and kind of spend some more time. I really wanted to go and walk in the like downtown historic Gettysburg area, because there's some really cool looking shops that we passed. But again, I don't think we're gonna have time to do that this time.
Yeah, it was really neat to see a bunch of the artifacts in there and the different types of guns that, and everything was just so immaculate. Everything was restored.
Yeah.
And so it was really neat to see, I don't know, just that stuff was actually real. You know, you see it in the movies all the time, but it's neat to see, you know, the actual real stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So, all right, we're gonna continue on the driving tour and see what else there is to see. Guess what I did while we were walking up?
What did you do?
I started the truck with my phone. I missed that.
That is so, like, first world, 21st century.
I know, but it's so awesome. It's kind of crap that we have to pay extra to start my truck via the Chevy app, but whatever. It's cheap enough, and it's super cool. Well, because here's the thing, right? So, normally, if I remote start it with the key fob when it's been sitting outside for a while, you have to get so close to the truck for the key fob to work, and it really doesn't give your AC enough time to actually do anything. So the phone app works.
Yeah, because you can do it from how far away? A few miles if you wanted.
I could do it from across the globe if I wanted to.
Okay.
Yeah, as long as I have internet access. And she's purring. Thank you.
Right over here.
This is where the Battle of Gettysburg kind of started. We had the Confederate troops coming in from the north and the west, and they met up with the Union Army right here. Now, I don't know all the super duper details. I read it all. I couldn't regurgitate it if I wanted to, but this general area right here is where it all started. It's really, really neat to see all this. And that barn right there, that is the barn that was here when it all started. So really, really neat to see this. I don't know what these are. But they're really pretty. I mean, they're not colorful or anything. They're just green. All of this, whatever this is here in the field.
Kind of looks like corn, but it's not corn.
Yeah, they kind of do look like little tiny corn stalks.
Yeah, and then it's got this flower, this something grown out of the top.
Yeah, we'll have to look it up and see what it is. And I don't know, maybe put it right above her head. I don't know. Going to read it off of the monument because I'll screw it up if I don't, but this is the Peace Eternal in a Nation United monument. And as we were headed up here, we're listening to this little app that I'll let Candice talk about in just a second, but as we were headed up here, I learned through this app that's narrated that this whole Battle of Gettysburg was actually not a planned battle. It was just Union and Confederate troops that landed on each other here, and it turned into this big thing.
So the app is the National Park Service, so the NPS app, and they've got just about every national park that you can find on here. You get all the details, where the visitor center is, what amenities they have, all that good stuff. But then they also have hiking trails, if there are any, and this one happens to have an auto tour. So we're here on the auto tour, and it's just taking us literally step by step, and there's some audio, and some of the stops even have a little bit of video that you can watch as well.
And it's all, it's if you follow it, you can follow it chronologically, right?
Yes.
Like he tells the story of the Battle of Gettysburg chronologically as you go through this tour. So
yeah,
really cool. We're not gonna give you the whole history of all of this, but anyway, I just wanted to show how dumb I was that I didn't even know that this wasn't a planned battle. This was just them happening across each other.
Oops.
And it really just kind of blew up. Mm-hmm. There's so much about this that's just impossible to imagine or impossible to fathom what it was like standing up here and just being around these huge cannons firing out over these fields, just the chaos, the noise, the confusion, I think just would have been more than a lot of people could handle. Okay, pretty exhausting day for us. I mean, we had a travel day. It wasn't that far.
Mm-hmm.
It was only like a little over an hour for the travel, but we had to set up and, you know, or tear down and set up. It's just been a long day. So we're on our third stop here along this auto tour,
mm-hmm.
and we're going to call it a day.
Yeah, so the tour is really cool, especially if you use the app and you get that narration. Each of the narrations is probably 5-10 minutes, roughly.
So it's an app, right? It's an actual app?
Yes.
Okay, so we'll put what's the name of the app again?
It's the National Park Service, so the NPS app. And yeah, we'll put the link down in the description. It has all the information that you're going to need for every national park that you can go to, historic sites, monuments, all that.
And they have tours going on here too that last about 4 hours. And I think you need about 3 days to really take all this in. And to be honest with you, I think that the guided or the self-tour, the self-guided tour with that app, with all of that narration, is plenty. I don't think you need the tour guides, because the narrator on the tour guide, this guy knows his stuff. Mm-hmm. I think it's just actually a recording of him giving a tour is what it sounds like. And this guy, I mean, he's really good in that narration. So that's how I would do this. As a matter of fact, we're already talking about coming back here, maybe not next summer, but maybe the summer after. Mm-hmm. And we're talking about how we want to do that, maybe with some e-bikes to take this tour.
The one gentleman was saying, if you spend 1 minute at each of the monuments, it'll take you 2.5 days to do it. So you obviously cannot see every single monument, but you can hit the highlights. There's like 16 stops, and they say, you know.
Yeah, and we're talking about coming back. When we come back, we'll do, you know, some of this tour or self-guided tour in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Go grab some lunch downtown in Gettysburg, mm-hmm. and then mess around, you know, in all the downtown areas in the afternoons.
Super cute downtown area.
And this is just a super beautiful area. Yeah. I mean, look at this behind us over here. I mean, Pennsylvania is a beautiful state. I don't know how I never knew this. But anyway, we're going to wrap this up. We're going to go back home. We're going to make some Mexican pizza for dinner.
Mm-hmm.
So, all right, guys, we'll see you later.